The big moment for Emma Harrison.
Emma Harrison is having a great day. She is looking at herself in the mirror. She thinks, I can become a famous actress, I just know it. She pulls a letter from her bag and reads it again.
Dear Ms. Harrison, please come to the movie studio on Tuesday at 10 a.m. Then Mr. Thompson wants to meet you.
Emma picks up the phone when it rings. Oh, Samuel, it's you, she tells him. Today is a big day for Samuel. His car is new. It's smooth red and just gorgeous. Samuel thinks that Emma likes men who drive fast cars. I can now let her go. He puts a phone in his car and then calls Emma's number. Hi, Emma, Samuel says. Would you like to go for a ride in my brand new car? Okay, Emma says in return. I can go to the movie studio with you. Samuel takes a car to Emma's home. Emma. Samuel exclaims. I adore your dress. And your hair. You look lovely. Thank you, Samuel, says Emma. Let's go. Mr. Thompson wants to talk to me at 10. Samuel drives fast down the road. Wow! You're such a skilled driver. Emma exclaims. Samuel is delighted. He isn't looking at the road, but rather at Emma. He didn't know that there was a stop sign at the end of the road. Which way do I go? What's going on? Samuel wonders. He can see a lot of trucks, but he can't see any cars. Follow that large truck, Emma says. He follows the truck, which turns to the right. Samuel, on the other hand, keeps going straight. Emma asks, "Where are we?" Hey, Samuel exclaims. We've got a problem. Close your eyes, Emma. Don't look. The car begins to go up. You can open your eyes now, says Samuel. Look, it looks like we're back on the road. He drives over the grass until he gets to the road. It is very wide and long, and there is a row of lights on one side. Look at this, says Samuel. On the road, our car is the only one. Let's go faster. Emma laughs. I love fast cars, she tells him. Emma hears a noise coming from behind her. She stops laughing and asks, "What's that?" Oh no. An airplane. Why is an airplane flying over this road? Samuel doesn't reply. He keeps going at a fast speed. He stays in front of the car while the plane flies over it. Emma begins to cry. She yells, "Samuel, what are you doing? Don't drive. I'm ready to leave." The car doesn't stop for Samuel. It's okay, Emma, he says. No problem. Don't forget, we're going to the movie studio. You have to be there by 10. Emma thinks of Mr. Thompson and looks at the time. You're right, she tells him. I'd rather not be late. Let's pick up the pace again. Samuel leaves the airport by following the exit signs. Long lines of cars jam up the road to the airport. Samuel can no longer go fast. He asks Emma, "How far is it to the studio?" "About a mile," is what she says. "This road is terrible," Samuel says. "Let's go on down there." Samuel steers the car onto a small road. Now he can go faster again. But all of a sudden, the road stops. Samuel doesn't stop. He drives through the grass and between the trees. A river comes into view. There's a bridge, but it's only for people on foot. Samuel thinks as he looks at the bridge. He then says, "Watch this." Emma knows a lot about Samuel. She yells, "No. Stop, Samuel. Please. I don't know how to swim." She wants to jump out of the car, but Samuel drives onto the bridge. Emma's face turns pale. She has no voice. She puts her eyes shut. Samuel comes to a stop at the end of the bridge. He says, "You see? It's simple, right?" In one of the cars, a very important person is watching Samuel, but Samuel doesn't notice him. He starts the car up again and drives up to the road. Now, they are in front of the cars. "Look!" Emma exclaims. "We are getting close to the studio." "Oh, Samuel, you're an incredible driver." The car stops at the gate to the studio. The man asks, "Whom would you like to see?" "Have you got mail?" "You can't get in if you don't have a letter." "I have a letter from Mr. Thompson," says Emma, "but it's at home." Samuel is very angry. Mr. Thompson wants to see her at 10 o'clock, he tells her. "Open up the gate." "I'm sorry, but I can't," says the man. Samuel steps on the gas and turns the steering wheel. The car speeds up. "Hey," yells the man. "You just can't." The car is now racing away from the gate on two wheels. Emma gets out of the car at the entrance to the studio. "Go in, Emma," Samuel says. "You are a star, and I have faith in you. The job is yours." Emma goes to the door and knocks. At the studio entrance, a long, black car pulls up. A big man with a cigar walks out of the door. The man asks, "Are you from the circus or something?" "You drive off the highway, under an airplane, over a footbridge, through the gate." "What's your name?" "My name's Samuel," Samuel says. "I enjoy driving cars." "Who could you be?" "I'm Mr. Thompson," says the man. "I'm in charge at this movie studio." "Do you want a job, Samuel?" He wants to know. "What kind of a job?" Samuel inquires. "I need a driver for my new movie," explains Mr. Thompson. "This is a very hard job." "Can you drive off a building's roof?" "Piece of cake," says Samuel. "Can you drive a car into a river?" "Of course," Samuel replies. "Excellent," says Mr. Thompson, giving Emma a look. He asks, "Are you the Harrison girl?" "You're not tall." "I want to meet a tall girl." "I apologize." "Hold on a minute," Samuel says. "If you want me, You have to take Miss Harrison too. He gets in his car. Stop. Don't leave. Mr. Thompson says, "Wow." He takes another look at Emma. He asks, "Can you swim?" "No problem," Emma says. She shows how well she can swim. All right," says Mr. Thompson. "You got it. Miss Harrison, you will also begin on Monday." Emma was shocked by how lucky she was. She would have a chance to follow her dream of becoming an actress starting on Monday. She thanked Mr. Thompson and ran back to Samuel, who was waiting in the car with great excitement. When he heard that Emma had done well, it made him happy. They got in the car, excited and looking forward to the days ahead. Emma and Samuel became close as the weeks went by on the movie set. Samuel turned out to be a good and brave driver.